వందేహం శ్రీగురు శ్రీయుత పదకమలం. We can float one Sputnik in the sky, and we take so much credit that we have become very, very great scientists. We don't care for more. This is foolishness. Foolish person will say like that, but one who is intelligent, he knows that God is floating millions and trillions of planets in the sky, and what we have done in that comparison. This is intelligence. We have become very much proud of our scientific knowledge, and therefore at the present moment we defy the existence of God. Sometimes we say that I have become God now. These are foolish statements. We are nothing in comparison to the intelligence. He is also intelligent. Because we are part and parcel of God, that we can study what is God if we simply study ourselves. Just like if you study a drop of sea water, if you analyze chemically, you'll find so many chemicals in that drop. So you can understand what is the composition of the sea, the same composition, but in greater quantity. That is the difference between God and ours. We are a small gods, we can say, a small gods, tiny, sample gods. Therefore we are so much proud. But we should not be proud because we should know that all our qualities are taken from God because we are part and parcel. So originally all these qualities are there in God. And therefore Vedanta Sutra says, what is God? What is absolute truth? Athata Brahma Jigyasa. When inquire about God, about the absolute truth, the answer is immediately given, Janmadasya Jataha. The absolute truth is that from whom everything comes, everything emanates. So everything is coming from God. He is the original source of all supplies. Now, what is our position? There are innumerable living entities. Nitya nityanang chetanas chetananang. That is Vedic information. God is also a living entity like us, but he is the chief living entity. And we are also living entity, just like one father. Father may have got 20 children, 20 sons. Formerly they used to have 100 sons. Now the fathers have no such power. But in the up to 5,000 years ago, King Dhritarashtra gave birth to 100 sons. Now we are saying that we are overpopulated. But that's not the fact. At the present moment, where there is the question of overpopulation? Now, how many of us giving birth hundreds of children? No, nobody. But formerly, a father could give birth to 100 children. So there is no question of overpopulation. And even there is overpopulation, we get information from the Vedas. Eka jo bahunam vidudhati kaman, that one chief living entity, God, he can maintain innumerable living entities.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.